Sir, I join my colleagues to support the motion of thanks on the address of the Honorable President. The progress made in different fields in the country in the last 5 years by the government under the able leadership of UPA Chairperson Srimati Sonia Gandhi and the Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh and the new policies which were envisaged in the next term have been duly highlighted in the Honorable President's address. Madam, you can see the country's growth rate, a standard of living of people, employment, education, and health sectors, and for that matter, any other field. Our country has done a tremendous progress in the last 5 years like never before. What is to be appreciated is that the people of this country, both young and old, have accepted and approved the performance of the UPA government. That is the reason why people have given clear mandate to the UPA to go ahead with these developmental policies in the near future. The world economies are sinking and they are jeopardy under unprecedented recession, but our Indian economy has remained well protected due to the policies adopted by the government. The loan waiver scheme of the tune of ₹7,000 crore for farmers has not only provided the necessary fillip to the agricultural sector but also put an end to the lamentable suicidal deaths which were witnessing for quite a long time in many states. It is very commendable having ushered in the path breaking Right to Information Act. This government is empowering the citizens by announcing a time-bound development program which is to be implemented in the first 100 days and not in years. The common man can seek the details of the actual performance achieved under this program, thereby creating a sense of accountability for those who are entrusted with the responsibility of implementing the program within the time frame. The commitment to enact the Women's Reservation Bill within a time frame again shows the earnestness of the sincerity of purpose of this government. Once this becomes a law, it will further transform this society, which was the dream of Sri Rajiv Gandhi ji. It was his dream to allow women to have an important role in the transformation of the country. The Home Ministry's effort to beef up coastal security after 26/11 terror attack should also be a special emphasis and focus on Goa, as it is one of the most popular tourist destinations on the world tourism map. the massive expansion in the higher education proposed in the 11th five-year plan must have a couple of central educational institutions to be set up in Goa. The discontinuance of the central government scheme of giving tax holiday to industries has greatly affected our state of Goa, as no new industries are willing to come and some of the old industries have shifted to other places. This has affected the employment generation in the state. Our state is heavily dependent on tourism industry, as the tourism industry is mostly seasonal. It does not offer employment throughout the year. My suggestion was that this scheme, which was there for giving tax holiday, which was stopped, should have been done in stages so that these industries which have run away from the state may come back and unemployment problem can be solved. In my constituency, I have around 20 assembly segments. 2 crore is not enough. I hope other honorable members will also agree with me that this has to be increased to rupees 6 to rupees 8 crore so that we can do justice to every assembly segment in the state. I would also like to bring to the notice of the Honorable Minister that in every central institution we can recommend 2 names. Madam, there are 5 or 6 central institutions in each constituency. So I would again request that every minister should be allowed to recommend at least 2 students in each institution in that particular constituency. This should be done only for the Lok Sabha members, as the Rajya Sabha members can recommend anywhere in the state. It is because so many people approach us and we cannot do justice. Madam, referring to the golden quadrilateral, I would request the Honorable Minister one thing. We have got 3 bridges, 2 small ones in the south and the other huge bridge as Zuari, which is the artery of Goa. I would request the Honorable Minister to look into this so that these bridges are taken up immediately, because already the alignment has been fixed. If anything goes wrong with our Zuari bridge, South Goa will be cut off from North Goa. Madam, with these few words, I appreciate whatever points which have been mentioned in the President's address. I would request my colleagues and the whole House